Well, now to the path forward. County jails are getting overwhelmed by inmates that technically don't even belong to them. Now, this coming after a court ruling on Tuesday forced county jails to hold on to IDOC inmates in an effort to stop the spread of COVID-19. News Channel 20's Matt Roy joining us now with the problems that these counties are now facing after this ruling went into effect for the community. Matt?
Stacy, John, the battle between the IDOC and the Illinois Sheriff's Association is starting to get ugly. Some jails, like Sangamon County's, are now over capacity due to the IDOC inmates that they have to house.
We're at the tipping point of that 350 number, and if we could get rid of those 22, that would take us down to a more manageable number.
Campbell says the normal capacity of the Sangamon County Jail is 318, but right now they sit at 352 because they're housing IDOC inmates. This creates a capacity issue as well as financial issues for the counties.
Whether it's a medical cost, it's transportation cost, it's workman's comp issues, there's a lot of issues that we could be responsible for that normally we wouldn't be and shouldn't be.
The divide stems from mandates by Governor Pritzker and the IDOC originally halting transfers. Now, transfers are allowed, but with limited numbers and with protocols that sheriffs say they can't follow.
It's got to be some give and take here between the Department of Corrections and working with us and actually having conversations with us about how to make this work.
In a statement today, IDOC spokesperson Lindsay Hess said, "We're committed to working with county jails to accept new admissions in a manner that protects the health and safety of staff, the incarcerated population, and the surrounding community." Hess also says since August 3rd, there have been 1,226 inmates transferred, but none since the ruling on Tuesday. Campbell says if more transfers aren't accepted soon, releasing low-risk inmates is going to be their only option.
And there's only one way to create more space, and that is to move some of these misdemeanors out.
You know, more crimes get committed. Unfortunately, people have to go somewhere. I mean, that was the whole point of setting up a prison system, right? So, I mean, so you had somewhere to go.
McKaychick says every minute that these IDOC inmates are in county facilities, it's costing county taxpayers more money. Now, Hess also said that the IDOC was working on a plan to reimburse the counties for the extra costs of the inmates. But since the lawsuit was filed on August 3rd, there hasn't been any communication of the sort. Reporting live in Springfield, I'm Matt Roy. John, Stacy, back to you.
Thank you, Matt. In a separate statement from the governor's office, they say that the exact same thing as the IDOC did.